Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to customise your ribbons and tabs at the top here. So for those of you working with a Mac, I'll show you how to access the controls, and then I'll show you how to access it if you're working in Microsoft 365. So if you go up to Word and you go to Preferences, you'll see this menu has an icon named Ribbon and Toolbar. So if you just click on that, then you access this menu. And it's this menu that we need to change our toolbars and ribbons. Now, if you're working in 365, I'm just going to show you some screenshots. So you need to go up to File here in your interface. Then you'll be presented with this menu here. You need to go down to Options, and then you will access this menu here where you need to go down to Customize Ribbon. So they're very similar once we get to this point here, but that's how you access it in each different interface. So let me go back to Preferences, Ribbon and Toolbars. So you need to be on this ribbon button here, and you have two different sides to this menu. Our main tabs are over here, so that's Home, Insert, Draw, Design, Layout, etc., which run across the top here. And then on this side here, you've got a list of all of your different tools. Now at the moment, by default, Word will show the most popular commands. But if you click on the drop down, you can see you can select from commands not in the ribbon, or all commands, and various other options as well. Usually you'll want something like commands not in the ribbon to add those that aren't there. But if you want to customize your tabs along the top and introduce an extra ribbon, you might want to select from all commands, because you might want to just repeat them, but just in a ribbon that suits you and has all the commands you use on a daily basis. So if I click all commands, you can see that they're now all listed in alphabetical order, and you can simply go down and click on the ones that you want, and I'll show you how to do that now. So just to be clear, your ribbon, we're currently in the Home tab here, and along here is your ribbon. And this is made up of a number of different groups, and the groups are split by these bars here, as you can see. If you wanted a new tab and you wanted to customize that tab with all your favorites in, or your most commonly used icons and tools, all you need to do is click Add, and you go down to New Tab. And once you've got this new tab, you can then rename it. So if I click on the new tab here, go down to this circle with the three dots and select Rename, I can now rename this. Let's rename this to Work. And let's just click Save. And then click Save. And then, as you can see at the top here, we have that tab called Work. Now, if I was to click on it, there's nothing in there. And that's because we haven't essentially put anything in our ribbon. If you want to go and delete it, again, exactly the same process. Go back to Ribbon and Toolbars. All you need to do is to search for your Customize tab, click on it, and just go down to the minus tab there and click Save. And again, you can see it's now gone. If you wanted to add commands to your toolbar, let's say we're in the Home tab now, which is here. And you can see all the different groups. So clipboard at the top here, if we click on the drop down, you can see it contains these elements here, which of course are these elements to the far left. Along with that, we have font, paragraph styles, voice and sensitivity, and these are all these groups here along the top. So let's say we wanted to add some more. So unfortunately, what you can't do is add things to a group. So let's say, for example, I wanted to add something to clipboard. If I clicked on clipboard, went along to, let's say, for example, bullet points. If I clicked on bullet points and I went to this arrow here to move it, you'll see this instruction comes up, which basically means you need to add a custom group in order to add your custom icons. So what I would need to do is go to my clipboard, click Add, and click New Group. Again, I can rename this new group. It doesn't matter because it's not going to appear, so you can just keep it as New Group. But if you wanted to rename it, just click Rename. And then at the top here, let's just name this Work and click Save. And then if you wanted to add your custom icons, again, let's go to bullet points, click on this arrow here, and you can see bullet points will be placed into that group. Let's just add a few more. Email, fit to window, email, click the arrow, fit to window, click the arrow. So we've put three icons or tools into that group. If we now click Save, and you can see the tools have now appeared here. Now you can move this if you don't want it here and you want it somewhere else in the ribbon, you can. And you can also take out these words if you want to. So again, let's just go back to our customization menu. Let's go back to work. So if we wanted to move this to the end over here on the ribbon, all we have to do is click on it and drag it down to the bottom. Let's just move that. You can see there's a little bar that should come up. There we go. And once that little bar comes up, you can move it to the bottom. If you click Save, you can see that's now moved those new tools to the far right. If we want to take out the words or the names of the tools, you can see bullet points here. All you need to do is select it, go down to the circle with the three dots, click Rename, and then you just simply have to delete the name and click Save. When you hover over it, the name will still appear as it normally would in the rest of the icons or the tools. Let's just rename all these and get rid of the names. Click Save, and you can see now all the names have gone from below if you just wanted to make them that little bit smaller. Once again, if you want to get rid of them, you can just go to the group again, click on the tool you want to remove, and just simply press this minus button here. And you can do that with all of them if you want to and start again. If you want to get rid of the group, again, just select it and press the minus tab there. And then go ahead and click Save. Now, we also have this quick access bar at the top here, which is Home, Save, Undo, Redo, Print, etc. If you want to change that, you simply click on the menu again and go to the Quick Access Toolbar. Now, the Quick Access Toolbar, you can see all your commands are in here. And if you want to add them, you can simply scroll through this menu. And don't forget, we've got this drop-down menu here. So at the moment, Word is only showing popular commands. If you want to show all of the commands, you just click All Commands. And then you can scroll through. They're all in alphabetical order. And you've got every single command here to choose from. And all you need to do is just simply add one or click on it, click the arrow, and you can see it will be added here. And if I click Save, you can see now it's appeared in the quick access bar at the top here. If I want to go ahead and delete it, quick access, click the one you want to delete, and then click minus and save. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.